Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our press conference here in the Carlton Hotel. Good morning to those who are here with us and also those who are watching our online streams. My name is Frederika Halasova, and I will be opening this press conference of Starmus, the global festival of science communication, which will be taking place in Bratislava, Slovakia next year, supported by our leading cybersecurity company, ESET. Today's press conference is actually taking part in the middle of ESET Science Award Week, which the company organizes every week. But now, every year, sorry, that would be very often. But now, allow me to introduce the speakers and our guests that you will be hearing from today. To my left, science popularizer and editor of the astronomy magazine, David Eicher, then Nobel Prize winning scientist, Professor Michel Mayor, and in the middle of all of this, and also of this row, astrophysicist and co-founder of the Starmus Festival, Dr. Garrick Israelian. To his left, the legendary musician, artist and composer Jean-Michel Jarre, then CEO of ESET, Richard Marco, and director and producer Todd Miller. Each of them has exciting news to share with you today and new information about the festival that will be happening next year. The journalists who are here with us today will have the possibility to post questions after the end of the press conference, as well as conduct individual interviews. But now, let me pass the floor to Dr. Israelian, the co-founder of the Starmus Festival, for the opening remarks.
Thank you very much. Welcome, everyone, to Starmus press conference. Probably you know that the first kickoff press conference took place in London and Bratislava last May with our board members, with Brian May, Jane Goodall, there was Martin Rees, Mary Calder, Richard Marco, Tony Fadell, and Emmanuel Charpentier were all members of our advisory board. And first, I want to thank ESET for partnering with Starmus to make Starmus 7 possible in Slovakia, in Bratislava. You know, in the past, we always collaborated as partners with governments, with public organizations. It's really the first time we are partnering with a cybersecurity company, with a tech company, a company which is pushing science, which is supporting science, and also science communication. So we are very happy with this new collaboration we have, in this case, with ESET. And today we are here to announce several things. The first is we will announce several new speakers. Most of them are in the business of artificial intelligence and machine learning, world-class specialists. And we will announce new artists. I will speak about this later. We announced a Starmus film, the first film about Starmus in 10 years. Finally, we produced a film about Starmus 6, which took place last year in Armenia. And we announced the School of Astrophotography. And we announced new partners. Omega, a watch maker, is again partnering with Starmus. We are very happy with this partnership we have with Omega. The representative of Omega is here today to confirm their support to Starmus. You probably know that they are making special watch for Stephen Hawking Medal winners. In fact, Jean-Michel Jarre and Todd Miller have those watches already and the medals.
I don't have it today, but
And so thank you, Omega, for partnering. And we are also partnering with the Blue Planet and several other organizations that will be announced. Today we have a countdown. We start a countdown to Starmus 7. And I want to confirm that we will continue with the same format as before, which means we will do a star party, we will do astrophotography school, we will have amazing science camp, which can attract 100,000, 200,000 people like we did in Armenia. In Armenia, we organized more than 80, about 100 lectures outside Starmus venue. So those 100 lectures took place at different universities, different schools. We took a complete country with all Nobel laureates, astronauts, lecturing everywhere in the country, not only in the same venue. So this was a part of a Starmus city program or a science camp, what we call for 4 days. This is a completely educational program plus entertainment, because we also had local bands and also bands, artists invited from Europe to join the science camp. So it's really very much entertaining. event and with a strong educational component, right? So this is the power of Starmus that can bring more than 100,000 people. So these are the main topics of today's announcement, and I will finish with this now and then.
Thank you, Dr. Israelian. We will start with the announcement of the new science speakers for Starmus 7. So David Eicher, who is also the member of the Starmus Advisory Board, you may know. Tell us who will come to Bratislava next year.
Thank you. And we have a nice problem that we're in, and that is that we're in the most exciting era in the history of science we've ever had, which is a good problem to have. In the core fields that we tend to think of, astronomy and astrophysics and planetary science and cosmology, but in all the sciences, really, we represent. And of course, our theme on Earth is going to incorporate some new thoughts and ideas as well. But really, physics and chemistry and biology and all of the sciences and sociology, even, we will get into here. So it's going to be a very broad program. Last time in Armenia, we had more than 50 speakers here, there, and everywhere. So I'd like to mention a few highlights here. We will have Garrick Israelian speaking, which is not a surprise. Brian May, another one of our advisory board members, of course. Jane Goodall, the leading primatologist on Earth, will be with us and is on the advisory board. Martin Rees, the astronomer royal in England, who's an expert on various things, including largely cosmology. Sylvia Earle, very well-known oceanographer, will be here with us, which is fabulous. Tony Fidel, another co-board member of ours, the inventor of the iPod and co-inventor of the iPhone, very clever, very funny guy. Kip Thorne, the world's leading expert on black holes, will be with us again, a very close pal. We will have the president from the United States of the National Academy of Sciences, Marcia McNutt, with us this time as well. Brian Greene, very popular physicist and astronomy and science popularizer. Emmanuel Charpentier, very famous microbiologist for her work on CRISPR technology and other things. Charlie Duke, our moonwalker friend, will be back with us. Jill Tarter, another member of our advisory board, who is the leading light in the world of SETI and the search for extraterrestrial intelligence. We talked a little bit about that last night. The distinguished Michel Mayor, Nobel Prize winner, will be with us, and explorer of exoplanets, among other things. Richard Marco, computer scientist, will be with us. Garrett Reisman, the astronaut. Chris Hadfield will be looking into Earth science and climate change concerns and what we can do about the planet, with Chris Rapley, Catherine Hayhoe, and others, experts. Chris Hadfield, the very famous astronaut and pal of ours, will be back. Lisa Kaltenegger, the director of the Carl Sagan Institute, who's an expert in many areas of astrophysics, and many, 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 many others. So it's going to be an exciting and unprecedented year again, and I know that we will have further announcements on key speakers that will be coming in the weeks in front of us as well. So that's just a brief taste of some of the core speakers we will have, and there will be many others.
Thank you very much. We are all already looking forward to all these inspiring minds, and it's really a pleasure to have one of them already here with us, Professor Michel Mayor, who will also say a few words.
Thank you. I've been asked to speak about the importance of science for finding solutions for the society. I believe it's very easy to answer. You have to look the clock and hear. Probably we are facing an absolutely terrific challenge related to the change of the climate. And Starmus probably have a very important role to play to convince people of the reality of this fact. Because still today, not everybody is really conscious of the importance of this point. And this is the role of science to find a way to escape. Okay. Sociology is not only a problem of science. Okay, sociology is also science, but to convince people of the need to act. And I will not list all the domain where science have a huge impact on the society. And you learned that the last week the Nobel Prize was given to two people having played an important role for the ARN messenger and discovering a very, very short time a vaccine against the COVID. And the best estimation we can do is this saved the life of 20 million people of this very quick development of the vaccine. And this is a success of science. And this is only a very short list, but you can continue for a long time on that. And you have the problem, Jane Goodall will evidently will be here and will speak about the huge change of the diversity of living species on the Earth. It's not a small detail, but evidently we are concerned with some emblematic species like the big monkeys and so on. But it's not only the case. I remember, 30 years ago when I was driving, sometimes you have a huge number of impact on the car from mosquito, from different insects and so on. And no, I didn't realize that we have no more impact. And in Switzerland, the estimation is at least 70% of this insect disappear. So we are living with this huge change of the diversity of the fauna, and we have to react. It's extremely important. And maybe what is not more visible is a long-term impact on fundamental science. Let's imagine 150 years ago, a man in England, Maxwell, wrote four equations to establish the link between magnetism, electricity, induction, and so on. Do you believe that he was dreaming what we have today? Television, internet, and so on. We are living we are the successor of this huge step of the related to the work made by Maxwell. And we can continue like this. We are living in a society completely dominated by the success or the progress or bad success of science. So the role of Starmus probably will be to popularize this aspect, because this, you have seen the large diversity of topics always discussed in the frame of Starmus. And I also confirm the huge importance of the what is called the city program, but it's not in the city, it's in the country program. So to have a huge number of lecture given in different school, university, public, and so on. So I'm a fan of Starmus.
Thank you, Professor. Thank you for reminding us also of the importance of this enormous challenge that we are facing. And now back to Dr. Israelian, who will tell us more about the music headliners of the Starmus Festival.
Yes, thank you, artists. So this time we will announce few artists who will join Starmus. First, I want to announce Robin Ince, who is a comedian, who shared the stage with Brian Cox and BBC Infinite Monkey Cage, who is appearing with Chris Hadfield. Robin is an amazing, super talented science communicator, really fun. He joined Starmus briefly for one panel discussion in Norway, but now he's coming for more. He's coming for more things, and it's really great to have Robin. And David Zambuka, another comedian, will join Starmus again. We have Tony Hadley from Spandau Ballet, amazing voice, incredible singer. Apparently, he's a fan of astronomy. He's really fan of science. And Tony is super interested to come and give his support to science communication, to Starmus Earth. Then I'm happy to announce Offspring, a rock band, noisy band. So probably a lot of people ask, why Offspring? Very few knows that Dexter Holland, the founder of Offspring, is a scientist. So he has a PhD in molecular biology from University of South California, and he's published amazing papers, Dexter. So I was in touch with him for several years, and we've been discussing to do something. So he may even give a talk at Starmus. So he'll not just come and rock the stage, but Dexter will give a talk. And there are many scientists, former scientists, who did PhDs and masters in science, and then they moved to music. Johnny from Coldplay is another guy who is also did master in astronomy, and very few people know that the founder of Genesis, Tony Banks, is a physicist, did master in physics, and so many cases. But now we are first starting to speak at Starmus about those cases, and I would say Jean-Michel Jarre would definitely have 5 PhDs in electronics, in AI, in all technologies, that's for sure. If he has time to write a thesis, he will get 5 PhDs done for sure. Now, finally, I want to introduce, and we are super happy and honored to have Jean-Michel Jarre as a headliner. I'm sure you know, everyone knows Jean-Michel Jarre. When you hear about Jean-Michel Jarre, you think, oxygen. Of course, and that's our generation. We grew up with oxygen, and that was a very big thing. But I want to talk about Jean-Michel Jarre, not only as a musician, as a founder, as a legend of electronic music, but also he did probably the greatest outdoor shows on this planet, the biggest outdoor shows has been done by Jean-Michel Jarre, with so many creative formula, with so many. And honestly, I have to tell you, I know music world, I know music business, I've been doing music myself and so on. I don't know any living person on this planet who has as much creative power as Mr. Jean-Michel Jarre. I have to be very honest with you. I know very good musicians, a lot of creative musicians, people who perform, excellent songwriters, you know, the music world, you know, but when it comes to finding some creative solutions in music and doing something hidden, maybe with people I will understand in 5 years, in 10 years, I think it's impossible to beat, to go ahead of Jean-Michel Jarre. His last albums, Oxymore, etc., and all his experiments with VR, with this, with that, just to take my breath away every time I follow him. And I said, this is impossible. You can't be doing all these things, just one person in his lifetime doing all this. So I'm super happy that we have Mr. Jarre as a headliner for Starmus 7 Earth. He has also done lots of projects to support environment for humanity. He has been an ambassador, UNESCO ambassador of peace, and you can read biography of Jean-Michel Jarre. It's so impressive. And one thing I have to say, I feel really honored to sit next to him and with Michel Mayor. It's one of the really unique things that at Starmus, you will never see a press conference like this in the world, any part of a planet, where you sit down with the top scientists and top artists. We have a filmmaker, we have musician, we have cybersecurity expert, we have scientists, science communicators. This only happens at Starmus. That's the only event where you have these diverse, amazing press conference with Brian Eno, with Hans Zimmer, and then Tyson, and then these, and astronauts, and so on. So this is super diverse and very important, very powerful. There's a lot of energy, a lot of meaning in this press conference. It's not just a press conference with us sitting. The press conference has a philosophy, it has a meaning, it has a goal. It shows what we are doing, why are we doing this, and what is the next step. So that's about Mr. Jean-Michel Jarre, and I'm sure we will have something very interesting, very unique for Starmus Slovakia, because as I said, Starmus is getting better and better. Now, as Anton said, that we have to now compete with Starmus Armenia, so it has to be better than Starmus Armenia, which is a serious challenge, I have to say. But it's good. We like challenges. We like challenges. We want to be creative. We want to do something extraordinary, something unique, something very different, something that people will say, wow, again, and again. So yes, this again should happen also with Slovakia. We have to do something extraordinary to support climate science, to support environment, and to see, and to bring finally the problems that humanity is facing to general public. because as you know, we have so many political conferences going on, dealing with climate change, environment, and so on. But I was counting there has never been anything talking to general public. So it's really the first time we are doing a festival dedicated to the environment net with general public, with the top climate scientists and top AI experts, and that has never been done. But this should have been done many, many, many times. So we are not going to look for professionals or media and politicians, but they're just the best experts talking to general public. So that's what will happen at Starmus 7.
Thank you, Dr. Israelian. Since his name was mentioned at least a dozen times, I'm left with nothing else than mention it again. Jean-Michel Jarre, if you may say a few words as well.
Thank you. So I don't believe what he's saying. This is his charm also. I would like to start by telling you a story about the way we met together. I was touring and I was playing at the Royal Albert Hall in London a few years ago. And after the concert, one guy came into my room backstage and said, there are two astrophysicists, they would like to talk to you. I say yes. And then two guys came in the room, and it was Brian May and Garrick. And I said, so the Queen has a new member. and Garrick, and actually, it's what it's when the idea of Starmus came along. These two guys had this fantastic idea to actually link the idea of astrophysics with music, and you know, astrophysics and music have a lot in common. The most important point is probably we are both worlds dealing with space and time. And this is probably one of the foundation and one of the first idea of the existence of Starmus. And then we started to talk together quite late that night about what Starmus could be. And the first idea was to do a concert with Queen and with Brian May and the rest of the band, including this new member. In Canaries Island, where Garrick is taking care of the observatory over there. And then it never happened, but then Starmus started. And I must say that if some of you saw the documentary did by Todd here, an amazing documentary showing what Starmus became. Starmus is, as Garrick was saying, and he's very humble, a major, major event for us and for the generation to come, with the most brilliant scientists beyond astrophysics, and also lots of different brilliant, probably amongst the brilliant musicians and artists of the planet. And you know, this year, the Starmus this year is actually evolving. It started by being focused mainly on astrophysics, and now, as we understand, I mean, Starmus is covering lots of different topics. And the idea of focusing for this seventh edition to the Earth, saying with very good idea that Garrick was carrying with Brian and the rest of the board, to say that by the end of the day, to understand space better, we should also understand our own planet better. And our planet is specific because it's one of the rare planets of our knowledge, having oxygen. And this is also one of the reasons why I'm so involved in this new session, because of the presence of oxygen. And having said that, I think that also doing such an event in Bratislava is very important to also celebrate European technology also and European science. The fact that with the evolving of AI, the evolving of technology, we as Europeans, we have also to create an alternative between the US and Asia. And I think we have a voice, we have our own vision, and this vision has to be shared also through over the, all over the planet. And I think it's also something that I'm quite attached to it, and talking with Garrick, Israelian, about all this, I think it's very important that suddenly giving a spotlight to such a country like Slovakia, I mean, also having so many fantastic musicians, fantastic artists, fantastic scientists also. So it's not neutral, it's not a choice by coincidence. It has for me, and for I think all of us, a real meaning. I've been in this country and in this town a few times. I played here, so I'm very, very excited to be a part of this new edition, and I think it's going to be something that we have to compete with Armenia. And this gentleman here, the head of ESET, said, okay, we have to not to do as well, we should do 200% more. So he gave me and he gave us, all of us, pressure even now. So I really wish good luck to this new edition, and believe me that I will be totally involved and committed to make this edition as special as possible.
Thank you, Mr. Jarre.
I will only add one more thing. I forgot to mention that we asked Jean-Michel also to give a keynote lecture about music and technology, because that's really something that he has been doing for all the years. So how technology is helping to get a next step in music. There's a lot of discussion about AI, writing music, you know, all those topics. So the best person who can tell you what is the future is Jean-Michel Jarre. So we ask him also to give a keynote speech at Starmus about music and technology.
So I would just to add one thing before giving the floor to all our other friends. You know, I won't touch even what Garrick just said, but just one thing. You know, art and science have so much in common. The fact that and especially probably in Europe, we had the tendency for too long to separate tech and culture. I mean, we should never forget that technology is dictating styles. It's because we invented the violin that Vivaldi did the music he did. Because we invented the synthesizer that people like me or some others are creating the music we do. And technology is actually bringing us tools to actually express timeless human emotions in phase with the society in which we are living in. And I think it's very important to understand and not to be scared about the future and be scared about innovation. I mean, it's probably in the human DNA to think that yesterday was better and tomorrow is going to be worse. If it was the case, we won't be here to discuss about the future. We should be excited by the future. We should be realistic. We should be pragmatic, and of course the emergence of AI, for instance, is going to be a huge, is going to create a huge change and a huge disruption. But I think for artists and for scientists, it's a fantastic opportunity, and for human beings, it's a fantastic opportunity also. And I would be very happy to exchange all these ideas during the next Starmus edition.
Thank you. We will be looking forward. And as we said already, Starmus is really joining art and science, and that means not only music, but also the cinematic experience. That is also why we have today here with us filmmaker Todd Miller, who you may know as the director of the award-winning film Apollo 11, and he will tell us now a bit more announcements.
Yeah, well, first off, thanks for having me, and I'm really excited to be on this this panel. And I was asked, how can art and science learn from each other? And I think Jean-Michel answered that quite eloquently. But in my case, dealing with cinema, I love being a filmmaker because it captures everything. It captures music. you know, writing, photography, cinematography, all the arts into one. And I find that the best filmmakers, you know, embody scientific principles in their art form. And likewise, the best scientists have to be artists. So I never have seen, you know, those occupations as two separate things. I think they coexist as one, and they're always better for it when they can incorporate both philosophies. I think the announcement is that we finally, for the first time, can announce that we put together a film about a Starmus event, and that was the Armenian Starmus that happened in 2022. And Garrick, ever since I met him back in, I guess it was 2019, 2018, somewhere in there, he's been telling me about this treasure trove of footage that he has from all these Starmus for, you know, the past 10 years. And back then, that was in Zurich, and that was Starmus 5. So we're coming up on 7 now. But a couple of months ago, he finally, true to his word, sent me a hard drive with pretty much what I can only describe as just a treasure trove of footage from Armenia. And I unfortunately wasn't able to travel to Armenia due to the pandemic and other factors. But I had no idea that it was going to be as amazing as what Garrick has said. He obviously has a lot of enthusiasm, which most of you in this room know. But I was blown away by his homeland. Garrick's Armenian, and what he put together on behalf of the country he comes from was nothing less than extraordinary. So I was not responsible for shooting in any of the footage, but he did ask me to work with him and Brian May to put together a film that showcased that festival, and I think we did a really good job, and it really showcases not only the science and the arts that are presented at a Starmus event, but it also and this is what's very unique I find in Starmus is it encapsulated the culture and the people. A lot of people came together to make this event happen, and there was over 200 volunteers, and it really influenced not only I would say the scientists that attended and the musicians, but also a lot of the young people that were in the population that came, many of which were from outside of Yerevan that came from the countryside, and for the first time got to look through telescopes, got to see Nobel laureates speak for the first time, got to hear amazing musicians for the first time, and it was clearly the biggest event that ever took place in Armenia in their esteemed history, and that was all because of Garrick. So no pressure on me to put together a film that encapsulated all of that, but I tried my best, and I think it was successful, and I'm really excited and honored to hear a lot of the announcements of the people that are going to be in Slovakia. I think if the stars align, we're going to bring some of our own filmmaking prowess and document a lot of the things that are going to be taking place here, and knowing the talent that's going to be here, and in particular how groundbreaking and just what a legendary artist and musician that Jean-Michel is, I think we can make something pretty spectacular. So I'm honored to be a part of it.
We will be looking forward to the next film for sure. And Starmus Earth will be taking place in Bratislava, also thanks to its main partner, the cybersecurity giant ESET. So we would like to hear a few thoughts now from its CEO, Richard Marko.
Thank you very much. And we already heard today that there is something beautiful in making. We heard about the big names that are coming to this country. And so it's an honor for this country. Top artists. And David commented in his speech that we are living these very great times when big discoveries are happening in science in different areas, biology, physics, and so on. This is thanks to advances in technology, in unprecedented international cooperation. So this is all very beautiful. On the other hand, we also know that we are living through times that are challenging. There are wars going on. We had a unprecedented epidemics going on in this world. Many people feel uncertain. There is a lot of disinformation that is being spread. And so we need to realize that the progress that we all love is not guaranteed. It's something that needs to be protected. And this is what we, as a cybersecurity vendor, stand for. And we believe in science. We believe that science, technology, art can really bring people together, can distinguish between what is reality and what is just opinion, what is disinformation, and so on. And I have to say that our role as a partner for this festival, and we are so proud of it and we are so happy about it, is also not a coincidence. Jean-Michel Jarre just told a beautiful story how they met in a hotel room, but we wouldn't be here and Starmus wouldn't be in this country if there wasn't activities that were happening here. We are at the week of ESET Science Award, and ESET Science Award is a week when we are announcing the winners, the best scientists that are doing their research and science in this country. And to decide who are those top scientists, it is decided by the jury that consists by the top scientists. And so in previous editions, we were so lucky to always have a Nobel Prize laureates as heads of the juries. It won't be different this year, and you already kind of can guess or already know that the presence of Professor Michel Mayor is also connected to this. We also have Dr. Israelian, who will also be a part of the jury. But we had in the previous edition, and many of you surely remember Professor Kip Thorne, who is an important part of Starmus. So then it's a very interesting story how one of the board members of ESET, Dr. Anton Zajac, how he got to know Professor Kip Thorne. And so through this connection, we got introduced to Starmus. We were invited to Starmus. I had an opportunity to go there and actually be one of the speakers, which was a beautiful experience in Armenia. And so we found out that there is really a connection that about many things we think the same. We consider the science, the education, the key pillars for the society, for the progress. And so then an idea appeared, like maybe there can be even more partnership here. Maybe we can bring this beautiful festival to this country and to do something together. And when I learned about this opportunity, it was like, of course, we want to be a part of it. And so we are a cybersecurity vendor. We are, unfortunately, in many cases, part of this nasty world. Many times we see bad things happening in the cyber world before they happen in the physical world. But we strongly believe that science research is important for the success of our company, but for the society overall. And it's not just the numbers and like people working hard, but also like people enjoying being together, sharing ideas, enjoying the best art that exists in the world, doing it in a way that is kind of unexpected, unprecedented. And this is what we hope and what we believe the Starmus in Slovakia next year will bring. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We will end the press conference with a few closing remarks from Dr. Israelian.
Yes, my final remarks will be, what do we expect from Starmus 7 in Slovakia? Maybe we can solve a problem with climate change with the festival. But at least I can guarantee that we will spread the message of Starmus and in the entire country, not only in Bratislava. We will definitely do lots of activities outside Bratislava. We want to involve schools and universities as much as we can, to make collaborations, and we will work with the government, we will work with all public institutions in Slovakia, because we want to spread this message. Starmus has never been about politics. We are much, much, much above any politics, because that's science and that's arts. So these are values of humanity which are above any political state, any political country, etc., etc. So there is no politics in Leonardo da Vinci. The Mozart doesn't have any political views, and neither Einstein had. So they are all much, much above any politics. So we are talking about values which represent humanity. When we meet aliens, that's what we have to show to aliens, not to anything else, which is much less than that, right? So this is what represents. We will have, I'm sure we will collect all our creative power to find something new, something different again in the 7th edition of Starmus, that to surprise everyone. So this can be considered as a countdown. So we are in October, and literally there is 6 months left till Starmus 7. And we will be working very, very hard, always with news, new names, new special guest artists, new scientists. So expect a lot of news from us during the next 6 months about partners, about any sort of agreements and competitions. We want to launch some competitions too. So thank you very much, and looking forward for the next 7th. 7 is a good number. 7 is a good number. It's a magical number. So the 7th festival should be quite unique. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We, however, do have one more information that we forgot to mention, and David Eicher will tell us which one it is.
And we'll quickly mention a couple of things that we did last time in Armenia for the first time at Starmus, and we're going to do them again. And of course, in Garrick's true tradition, we're going to do them bigger and better each time, which, you know, how he does this is magic. But we had a star party for the first time last time, and it's really a revelation to most people. We run around on our two-dimensional surface of Earth here, which is a pretty good planet, but that we need to take care of. And it doesn't occur to most people that you can go outside away from really bright lights and look up with a very simple telescope and see this big universe out there, and maybe something like 10,000 interesting objects in our solar system, and mostly beyond our solar system, in a small telescope. And so we'll do that again. We have a fantastic, incredible place that we're going to go to for this star party. I think we're going to have some rock and roll there as well, Garrick, and we'll have telescopes there provided for people. Often you see a magical look in the eyes of people when they get their first look at the moon or at Saturn or a galaxy far beyond, and that's going to be a very special night. You know, the weather, you know, it's gambling with weather, but we'll hope for the best with that. Also, for the second time, we'll have an astro-imaging school. In the last generation or so, it has become exponentially easier with technology as it marches on to take your own images of the sky in a variety of ways. And so we'll have a school with Michael Bakich, a colleague of mine from Astronomy Magazine, who's an expert on astro-imaging, and three teachers who are primary, very well-known imagers in the world. Damien Peach from the UK, who is sort of the greatest color astro-imager of planets these days. Chris Shure, who's an American in Arizona, who's a great imager of galaxies and nebulae. And Martin Ratcliffe, who again is a columnist and imager for Astronomy Magazine. So we'll have that to let people know how they can not only observe at the star party and discover those objects out in the universe, but capture their own images, whether it be simply with a phone or with more sophisticated equipment that will be their own little keepsake of the cosmos. So we'll be doing that once again as well, Garrick.
Thank you very much, and thank you for being with us this morning. It has been really packed with exciting information, and we are all looking forward to May 2024. And we will now end the online stream, so thank you to our viewers for staying with us. And we we will continue.